So I've been up and down on my dial here. Anything from like 7 to 20 to 23, maybe. Depending on what's happening. So if she keeps making the same mistake over and over again, which is obviously getting up, following the sticky finger. She wants to be right on your leg, right next to you all the time. If she keeps making that mistake, then I scroll up, right? I'm only gonna tell her a couple of times at the same level and if I'm not getting any traction, right? So I'll tell her a couple times and then I just immediately dial it up so that if I have to tell her a third time, it's a little bit higher and so on. And then I'll turn it up again. So if I have to tell her a fourth or a fifth time, it'll be a little bit higher. And there is such a thing as asking the dog for too much, right? But I'm not going that far. This is the furthest I've been. I just want her tolerant, staying in her down while I move away from her a little bit. And we'll build on that. We'll build on that. But it's not the most important thing. But she should be able to tolerate me just walking around a little bit here, right? I'm not going to the other side of the room or the building. I've mostly been within an arm's reach of her, and she just couldn't do it. Couldn't do it. So this is what she needs the most work with. And it is important because it ties into everything. She's very needy, very clingy, very impulsive. If I use the leash, which I usually don't, I try not to, I try to use spatial pressure and cognitive. If I use the leash to move her away, and I usually combine it with a little stim, she'll start chewing at the leash to try to cut the leash so she can get over here. So, this is what she needs the most. She's done a very good job holding this long, so I'm going to release her. And then we're going to do it again. It's going to be a very calm release, which is important. So if I go and I have a big deal and I have a big party, I'm feeding into that excitable, impulsive nature. And I want to downplay that. Let's go. That's it. I'm going to look at her. I'm going to touch her. Good. Neutral praise. Good. And then maybe we'll do a couple of very short downs. Another longer one again. So mix it up. Down. Down. Good. Now when I move away, no. Down. This is the best she's done, and she even rolled her hips to the side in a more relaxed manner. She's not relaxed. Much better than she was a few minutes ago, where she was right up on her conscience. Yeah. So if I catch her early, sometimes she'll go right back down, which is good. But so now I've told her a couple of times. So I'm going to dial this up from 13 to 17.
Very easily go up or down based on what I'm seeing.
probably just stay up there for now. But it just depends. No. See, now this is just too close to me. No. And I'm not going to move away from her. I'm going to move her away from me. No. No. So, because we have clingy she is? No. So sometimes, instead of, like, if you touch the dog, it gets them more clingy and worked up, which I think is what's happening here. So sometimes just using a firm body language and kind of doing this sort of thing, so I don't want to get too close to her right now, and she'll think I'm not happy with this, and I am, might be better. See, different dogs respond to different things. Down. Still on a 17. Notice I'm not even using the word break, and I could, there'd be nothing wrong with that. The word let's go is less charged. It's less charged. And I'm trying to downplay everything with this exercise. Get you. Just look at you. Let's do one more. Down. A lot of people are going to see that, especially the footwork trying to move her away from me, and they're going to feel like that's so mean. But if you use your hands, if you get down there with the dog and you're using your hands, to them, they're getting that need fulfilled. You're touching them, you use your hands for affection. And, you know, sometimes I even see people, they're actually stroking and petting their dog while they try to push them off them. That's not an effective strategy, guys. It needs to be more of a cold, firm, instructional, spatial pressure, body language, communication. It's just supposed to, you're trying to draw a boundary, okay? So it's not to be mean, it's to set a boundary, and you're not gonna do that if you're feeding into their neediness at the same time. That's not effective, you're gonna struggle. Walking behind the dog.